come there, hopefully, because he went under that punch first, he's going to be there to counter punch me first. So let's make a couple of angles. One, let's, one, two. Under and under. Just see where he is, stay low. Under and under. That's where he is, see that? He's right there to push me away from him. If there's nothing on, he's under, that's it. And again, he goes under that punch, he's under that punch. Without coming up, he can either turn me, he can push me away, or he can punch me. And every time that he's done that, if you notice really close, he stays as low as he can, so I can't hit him. It's all about defense as well. Having a good offense is usually the best form of defense, and that's what we're trying to get on air through to you right now. So he's under, stay low. Under, stays low. There's nothing there for me to do to him. And again, he can turn me. Okay? One, two. Side, side, under. Slip, slip, and under. Stay low. Nice on that. The secret is staying low because, again, offense, just being there. Pressure's not punching your opponent all the time. Pressure's a thought of you being hit. Like Mike Tyson, for instance, when he fought, even if he wasn't throwing punches, he was bobbing and weaving, he was this far away from you. And just that pressure, the thought of him getting hit, made his opponents get tired. And that's what we're trying to do. That's why that interval training and this training is so important to know. That if I'm just going to go under a punch and come back in front of my opponent, I'm going to get hit. If I'm going to go under and learn to pivot and learn to use these feet and learn to have good balance, I will not get hurt as much, I will not get hit as much, and we'll be successful in our fights. And the real secret to winning fights is making your opponent fight your fight. And usually if you're putting pressure on your opponent, your opponent finds it very, very hard to cope. Me, I was a pressure fighter. I tried to stick as close as I could to my opponent and put as much pressure on him as I could. A good offense is a good defense as well. And I thought that when I fought, that was my strongest point. Now I'm going to show you a few little tricks with this upper torso bag. I was just wishing all my opponents was like him and didn't have long arms. I would have been much safer in the ring. I could have still been fighting today if my opponents all looked like this upper torso bag. But now I'm going to just show you a few little moves on this body here, and I'm going to just show you the correct way to punch, the correct way to put pressure on an opponent. The correct way to put pressure on an opponent is having your hands nice and high, having good hip movement, being able to slip your punch. As we slip, being able to punch nice and short. If I come to here and I show this guy that I'm going to punch him, all that happens then, my opponent just drops his arm down, twists to the side, and he takes 50 to 60% of my power away from me because I showed him my punch. So it's very important. I slip that side, slip, boom, nice short punch. Slip, slip, boom, boom, nice short punch. Body, body, boom, nice and short. Everything's nice and short. We're rolling in there. We're putting pressure on our opponent. Making angles. Keeping nice and close. We don't want to get off him. We want to be nice and close. Just thinking, looking, working on your defense. Nice short. Again, if we get long, it's always pushing the jab out. It's not pushing it out too far. Pushing it out, just trying to blind him. Jabbing nice and high. Keeping that right hand up nice and controlled. Ready to throw that right hand. Always ready. Feeding the right hand. Boom. Right hand. Don't always have to throw it to the head or to the chin. Boom. We can throw the right hand to the chest. Very effective punch. Again, right hand to the body. Very effective punch. We've got to make sure that if we're going to throw those punches, that our left hand's nice and high. So, boom. Ready to block. Boom. Boom. Here's that nice long hook now. Again, it's coming from the feet. Straight right hand. This is good fun. This guy doesn't hit back. But that's the name of the game. We can put pressure on our opponent and keep him in a defensive mode. he won't be able to hit us back. Just a few other punches now. They're not conventional, but in a lot of fights, when you're fighting guys who are very defensive, they often work. This is going to be the right bolo punch. Again, we're just feinting with this hand. We're feinting. It's very important to have a good feint. As we feint, boom, that right hand bowls right over to the side of the temple, to the side of the jaw. But very important to feint. Let that guy think we're going to his body, boom, and bang, we hit him nice and hard. We don't even look at his head. We're just tapping away. We're looking here, feinting, boom. If this one lands, that one will finish him off. Very, very important. I'm going to try it on one of these guys here very shortly. Again, just walking, looking. Always good balance. It comes from the feet. Watch the feet. Feet are still there. Feet are still there. Same. Nice straight jab to the chest or to the abdominal area. But we're not looking again. We're feigning. Looking in the head. Nice straight body punch. Up. If he starts landing, your opponent will start to drop his hands. When he drops his hands, we balk with the left hand to the body. We feint to the body. And we shoot the right hand straight to the chin. Very, very effective punch. We've hit him to the body. We've brought his hands down. We feint. If that right hand lands, very important to be in position for that next punch. We have a lot of fighters today. They'll throw that one punch. All of a sudden, they're out of position to throw their second punch. Very important that after we throw that first punch, our legs are in the right position to follow up. Because that opportunity that we miss, we won't catch up. But if we miss that opportunity to knock him out, he might come back in the next round and it will haunt us. So we've got to make sure that when we're hitting, we stay in position to continue to hit our opponent. Very important again, all comes from good balance. Short punches, pressure, being able to make those angles. Moving. If you've seen Mike Tyson when he was at his best, he was always in there making angles. Always coming around the body, you know? Nice quick moves. Very important that these feet move quickly. Again, if you see every time that I hook, I'm not hooking back here. I'm making sure that I hook at my opponent. So my arm's not shortening and I'm missing with my punch. Every time I'm moving my body to land my left hook with maximum power, maximum weight behind my left hook. Here we go with it now. Good night. Just a couple of things that are illegal and we shouldn't do. One is the low blow. Another terrible thing that a lot of people have a bad habit is holding and hitting. Much preferable to use that arm. If this is here, I teach my guys to uppercut straight away. Obviously, rabbit punching. My old mate who used to do that. Not good, the bite is. None of that stuff's really good. But look, the most important thing, and hopefully the lesson that we've learned today, is a fit fighter is always a better fighter. If we're mentally prepared and physically prepared, we can get in the ring and do whatever we want to do. 99 times out of 100, the fight's usually won in the gym. If we do our preparation right, we'll get to the gym and do the job. We can all be knocked out, we're not invincible. But like I said, if our preparation's right and we've done the work, your trainer obviously knows you're going there to fight against somebody, he's picked the right opponent for you, we usually win the fights in the gym. It's all about preparation. So if we prepare properly, we'll be victorious. Thank you very much.
Check. Title Boxing's got you covered with 16 action-packed videos to get you in the best condition of your life. Boxing and conditioning experts Danny Campbell, Michael Rutherford, Jeff Finnick, and Russ Anber put you through the paces to show you everything you need to know to improve your speed, strength, agility, and stamina. How to wrap hands, hitting the heavy bag, medicine ball, obtaining the edge of speed, interval training, punching at angles, advanced techniques, explosive speed and power, mastering the basics, punch mitt secrets, getting bigger and stronger, dynamic speed and thrust, counter punching, working the corner, defensive skills and drills, body punching, and more. Get only the ones you want or get maximum impact with the entire series. Get the secrets of over 80 years of combined boxing and physical training experience in one action-packed video series. Where do you get it? Exclusively at TitleBoxing.com. TitleBoxing.com. If we don't have it, you don't need it.